welcome you all for this demonstration. Here, this is your final output after completing this burst test of a small pressurized component. Okay, if you complete this procedure, you will get this final output. Now let us start our demonstration. Okay. So here the explicit dynamic analysis has to be inserted in the project schematic window. Double click the engineering data. As usual, go to engineering data sources. Here you can see the variety of materials available in the engineering data sources. Select the explicit materials and drag down the outline of explicit materials, so you will be having more kind of materials available. The property have been defined already and it is installed here. So let us choose steel 1006 and add. Here I have chosen steel as my material. For verification, you can add your aluminium also. You can choose your own material. Select the engineering data sources. Close this engineering data. Now I have to download the geometry. Right click the geometry, import geometry. So burst_pressure.stp file is available. Now right click the model and edit it. Okay, so now our model has been imported to the setup environment successfully. You can verify the geometry. So this is called geometry number 1, and by default the structural steel property have been assigned. You can change this by clicking this icon and choose to steel 1006. Okay, now mesh, right click the mesh and accept the default mesh. Okay, by default you will be having this kind of tetrahedral meshes, and if you verify the statistics, nodes are around 3259 nodes. Okay, if you wanted to quadrilateral mesh, do the steps as follows. Insert method, select the geometry and select the body as element, choose it and choose the method as X dominant, and right click, insert sizing. Now let us define our sizing. We can choose 3mm element size, and again insert face missing. Okay, choose these faces, hold the control key and choose this inside and outside faces to avoid the irregularity or the shape warning limits. Okay, now right click and generate the mesh. Okay, so now you can see a structured mesh. Okay, now go to explicit dynamics, choose the analysis settings and insert end time as 0.001 second, that is within a millisecond it is going to apply for the pressure of 100 MPa. Okay, the 100 MPa pressure is going to be applied at the inside of the pressure chamber. Hold the control key and select the faces, apply it. Now pressure is applied uniformly inside the pressure chamber. Now I wanted to fix this at the top face of this small pressurized component. okay. So that is enough for the setup, okay. Now you have to solve this. Right click, insert, deformation, total deformation, and if you want the stress, you can want more stress, okay. No need to change any settings in analysis, okay. Just right click and solve this. The solver is initiated now. To initiate the solver itself, we need at least 3 to 4 minutes to initiate the solver. While solving this, you can check the solution information and on the solver output. And if you want, you can choose the energy conservation graph plot. So see, it is started now. The number of cycles completed here also it will be shown. The total work done and the total energy error, everything you can see it in the graph. We have to wait for some time to solve. Here my system is 4GB RAM processor, okay. After solving this, you can view the results. That is execution from cycle for me, it is around 1 lakh, nearly 1,83,000 cycles have been solved, okay. So now you can view the total deformation results, okay. Start from this, select this result set, and this is the starting time, okay. The next set is right click, retrieve this result. So see here, it is getting bulging, okay. And the next set, so again still it is bulged. Okay, at the fourth step, so it is bursted, okay. If you want, you can set the animation frame rates, that is 30 or 40 frames per second or 40 frames per 20 seconds or 1 second, and play the animation video, okay. So this is how this will be bursted, okay. And the stress result also you can verify. Okay, thank you very much. So if you like this video, please share to your friends. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment section. If possible, I will definitely answer your questions. Okay, thank you very much and have a nice day.